Windows 7 Start menu. By default, it's on the bottom left-hand corner of your monitor or screen, should I say. Go to it and right-click with your mouse and select Properties. Grab hold of it and bring it to the center of your screen. You have three tabs. I'm going to select the Taskbar tab. Lock the taskbar, meaning locking your taskbar. If you choose something else, just like I just done there, make sure you select the apply. Then it will change. Now, always write down what you're doing, just in case you've forgotten. Don't do too many steps forward. Just take your time and see one of these three, which one you prefer to have. I like lock the taskbar. Taskbar location on screen. Mine's on the bottom by default. Drop down menu, you can select it to the left, to the right, or to the top. I'll select it to the top this time, but you need to go and select apply. And you can see my taskbar now is on the top. To change it back, if you don't wish to have it on top, remember, write down and take notes before you do something. Mine was on the bottom, and I'll apply. And it's gone back to the bottom. Taskbar buttons, should I say. Once again, follow these as well. Three little steps there, but write down and take notes where you started from. And select apply if you wish. This little customize, read it carefully. When you click it, a window appears and it's the control panel. Later in these playlist series, I'll explain what these are. Okay, so by the moment, just follow the instructions on the taskbar. How do I customize the taskbar? Good tips there, and follow on step-by-step instructions, all provided by your Windows 7 operating system. Start menu again. When you right click the start menu, select properties, you bring it up to the center again, have a good look. We've just gone through the taskbar, now we got the start menu. It may appear straight by default rather than this one. However, we're in the start menu right now. There's a customize button there, and this button right here, as you can see, when it opens up, it has a lot for you select and choose what you want. Now, this is more than this actual video tutorial is about. There's a lot of changes you can go there, from the network to the pictures and so on. I'm just scrolling nice and easy. As you can see, there's a lot. Strongly recommend you have a bit of a look at it. Select what you think is right for yourself. Apply, of course. Have a look at the changes. Always write down notes, just in case you've forgotten or you don't want to have it displayed like that as it is. So have a good look at that, or use the default settings by just clicking that. Very simple. Now that's the customize section right there. Power button action is very important, that one, because you got the restart, computer on sleep, lock it, switch off. If you've got a network system, switch to users, or a shutdown. Now that's important to know, that how you want that. I've got mine set as restart. Although when I go to the start menu, I can also select shutdown. The final third piece right here, should I say. And you can read it through there. It's quite self-explanatory. And how do I change the way the start menu looks? Click that link. It's an internal link, and of course gives you a lot of features there, some drawings or images, should I say. And you can just click any of those links in there, it'll give you good help. Once again, the Windows Start menu, by selecting click on your right mouse, select properties, bring it down, or should I say bring it up to the middle. And the last one is the toolbars. The toolbars tab, you can check the address if you want, address, links, and so on. It's quite self-explanatory, so nothing really hard to work out. So as you can see, you got the start menu, taskbar, and this video is just a short demonstration how to use the start menu, taskbar, and the toolbars by right-clicking the start menu. I hope you enjoy. Bye for now.